Julia Gillard has defended APEC, even though the 20-year-old group has failed to meet a key target for free trade. The Prime Minister says progress is being made with billions of dollars in business and millions of jobs.
The redhead in the traditional Japanese theatre seems to have captured the Prime Minister's view on the worth of APEC. It's emphatically delivering.
If we can improve trade with our region, then we of course improve the prospects for Australian jobs.
Dismantling barriers to trade and cooperation still on the agenda, even though the developed nations have failed to meet the 2010 deadline. Significant steps making it easier to do business have been taken.
There's the cooperation that's led to the lowering of mobile phone roaming costs.
President Obama came face to face with the robotic future, comfort seals that respond to petting. And how's this for getting around? He's impressed.
That's what we're going to be driving.
Julia Gillard's getting the hang of these summits too in 3 days has been a help. Next weekend, she's flying to Portugal for the NATO summit. It's hard to argue with its importance. The future of our Afghanistan commitment is on the table. One APEC tradition has gone by the board. Japan failed to come up with a silly shirt. Smart casual was the order of the day for the class photo. The Prime Minister, a standout.
I seriously can't help you on what's happened to the APEC shirts.
The tradition started in Indonesia 16 years ago, and there have been some confronting outfits along the way. Next year in Hawaii, the tradition is sure to make a colourful comeback. In Yokohama, Japan, Paul Bongiorno, 10 News.